Hello and welcome to Tech This Week. The week saw a number of big ticket investments with the space tech segment stealing the show. Chennai-based Agnikul Cosmos and Hyderabad-based Skydude Aerospace raised $11 million for their Series A funding round. In today's episode, we'll be joined by Pavan Kumar Chandana, co-founder of Skydude Aerospace, to talk about the deal in the detail. But first, let's take a look at the top headlines from this week. Cryptocurrency market crashes, down 30%. The cryptocurrency market suffered its worst crash in over a year this week, with leading currencies crashing as much as 30% in 24 hours after a bull run that began late last year took coins such as Bitcoin and Ethereum to all-time highs. This came in the backdrop of Chinese regulators announcing a crackdown on cryptocurrencies earlier this week. Sophos uncovered 167 fake trading and crypto apps. British cybersecurity software and hardware company Sophos Group has identified 167 counterfeit Android and iOS apps used by the attackers to steal money from people who believed they have installed a financial trading, banking, or cryptocurrency app from a trusted organization. According to a report published by the company, attackers used familiar social engineering techniques, counterfeit websites, and a fake iOS App Store download page. They also used an iOS app testing website to get users to download the fake applications. Krafton opens pre-registrations for Battlegrounds Mobile India. South Korean gaming company Krafton has started pre-registrations for Battlegrounds Mobile India on the Google Play Store. The firm's latest Battle Royale offering for this market follows in the wake of the ban of its popular game PUBG nearly a year ago. The release date of this game is still being finalized, and as on date, there is no final word on its availability for iOS as well. Krafton said that the users pre-registering to play the title will be awarded with rewards such as new masks and outfits at launch. It also plans to announce in-game events and esports tournaments with partners closer to the release date. Notably, the game will be a tweaked India-specific avatar for PUBG Mobile, banned by the Indian government last September. Google I/O 2021 highlights. Technology major Google showcased a glimpse of its project Starline at the I/O conference held this week. With Starline's futuristic technology, it showcased that video calls would take on a whole new meaning as they would show each party as a dedicated 3D hologram. Apart from holograms, the flagship developer conference had a slew of announcements across the Google spectrum of products. The company claimed that its active Android users have now touched 3 billion, as opposed to the rival Apple, which claims a billion mobile users. Google also released a beta version of Android 12, which most Pixel users and partner devices such as Asus, OnePlus, etc. can install and try out. Some of the new features include better notification, changing color palettes, along with more controls for privacy and easier connectivity between Chromebooks and Android TVs. Auto Classifieds platform Cartrade files DRHP for 2,000 crore rupees IPO. Mumbai-based automobile classifieds platform Cartrade has submitted a draft prospectus with the capital markets regulator to raise about 2,000 crore rupees through an initial public offering. The offer constitutes 26.96% of the post-offer paid-up equity share capital at a face value of rupees 10. The issue will comprise an offer for sale of 1.23 crore shares by the company's investors and promoters. A total of 12 investors will offload their share as part of the IPO. With the IPO, Cartrade will be the first automobile classifieds platform to go public in India. Zenza Technologies to buy data engineering company M3BI for $30 million. Pune-based IT services firm Zenza Technologies all set to buy data engineering and analytics firm M3BI to bolster its advanced engineering capabilities. The acquisition includes an upfront payment of $21.60 million and performance-based deferred payments of $9 million over a 36-month period. The acquisition will be funded by internal accruals of Zenza. And in a statement issued by the company, it said that M3BI will help them strengthen their capabilities in the areas of data engineering, analytics, artificial intelligence, machine learning, and advanced engineering services. L&T buys stake in B2B software firm Help Lightning. Engineering and construction major L&T will acquire a 6.35% stake in Delaware-based remote virtual assistance application firm Help Lightning. L&T subsidiary L&T International has entered into an agreement to acquire the stake for a cash consideration of $2.5 million. The deal is expected to close by tomorrow, which is 22 May. Founded in 2019, Help Lightning offers a patent-protected mixed reality platform that enables virtual collaboration for field service personnel. At present, it has over 50,000 users in 88 countries and a team of 33 employees. It operates in the US and has a captive development center in Beijing. The company reported a turnover of $4 million in financial year 2020. Now let's take a look at the top funding deals of the week. This week, Mukesh Bansal-backed Skyroot Aerospace raised $11 million in a Series A funding round, which was led by the founders of renewable energy company Greenko Group. The startup is all set for its first launch vehicle, Vikram 1. My colleague Shubham Sharma spoke with Pavan Kumar Chantana, co-founder of Skyroot. Over to you guys.
How do you plan to use the latest Series A funding?
Yeah, so first thing is by expanding our team. You know, so we already have a good 70-member, rocket scientist team, which is brilliant. And we have been aggressively expanding over the last 6 months. And this will help us even expanding even further and to build a very good, better team, which can, handle the first few launches. So that would be the first point of utilization. And second is mostly, most of the capital goes into building the hardware, test hardware after the first launch. Typically, a lot of hardware needs to be tested multiple times so that we can get the confidence to do a launch. So this will go into building rapid manufacturing and testing of the hardwares so that we are good to go for a launch by mid next year.
Okay. What is the roadmap for the near future, the launch and the commercialization of Vikram 1?
Yeah, so I mean, first our focus would be, to get to, orbit reliably, so and prove our vehicle in the first couple of launches. And then once we become operational, we would be ramping up the production, depending on the market demand. We can do it, even up to one launch a week. Within a couple of years from there, and but immediately we could always do up to one launch per a month could be possible by 2023 itself. Yeah.
And finally, what are your views on the growing competition in the private launch space? Agnikul Cosmos also raised $11 million yesterday.
Yeah. Correct. So I think competition is always, great. And in fact, we should all also consider it as like more like a global competition because space is a global industry. Right. So there are like really good players emerging in the international market as well. And it's good that, Indian companies also have received good traction. So it's also it brings us good limelight overall in the international markets as well, right? So that way, it's like a really good that two Indian companies have raised funds enough to scale to the next level. That's a good sign overall. And the competition is always great and fun to even innovate better and find even better solutions to things and also it's always healthy competition always good for the industry as well globally. Right. And we have like a few players also Rocket Lab is very good player who is operational. We have done like almost close to 20 launches. And then Virgin and Astra are also ramping up to do more launches. They have done the initial launch. So that way competition is very healthy. And I think like Skyroot stands out from most of the competition by the kind of a level of innovation and cost efficiency involved and the rapid pace of innovation happening at Skyroot. So with that, I think we will stand out and we'll keep standing out going further as well.
Thank you for giving your time.
Other big ticket fundings this week include Pine Labs, which raised $285 million to grow its merchant commerce platform and online payment stack. The round is a combination of primary capital infusion and secondary stake sales by existing shareholders, including the company's founder and employees. The Delhi NCR-based company, which is headed for a public listing in 2022, is likely to raise more capital as part of the latest round. Next up, B2B commerce platform Moglix turned unicorn this week in a Falcon Edge and Howard Management Company-led round. The $120 million round also saw participation from returning investors Tiger Global Management, Sequoia Capital India, and Venture Highway. Earlier this week, global private equity firm KKR announced an investment of $95 million in omnichannel eyewear brand Lenskart through secondary stake acquisition. The investment will create partial exits for early investors TPG Growth and TR Capital, which bet on the company in 2014. Lastly, Agnikul, which is also a space tech startup, raised $11 million as part of its Series A round of funding led by Mayfield India. The company said that it will use the proceeds to build its technology infrastructure, launch ground testing, and expand its team. That will be all for this episode of Tech This Week. Do stay tuned in and logged on to techcircle.in for more interesting news and updates. Thank you very much for listening.